Sweet Dane Sweet. Goes to show you just what's in a name, doesn't it? Here's a comic book review.
This town deserves a better class of criminal. And I'm gonna give it to him.
The plan is to humor him until we discover his real agenda. Sweet Dan Sweet reviews Supergirl number 60.
Hey folks, how you doing? Comic Book Man here. Welcome once again to My Video Outhouse. It's time for
Sweet Talk with Sweet Dan Sweet and Comic Book Man. That's coming to you from Comic Book Man's Video Outhouse.
Located at Alternate Reality, which is the intersection of 111th and Kedzie in beautiful downtown Mount Greenwood.
Did we ever get that graphic of the guy laying in the gutter?
Not yet. We're working on that with you. You're going to be the guy.
Wait till about 2 a.m. today.
Alternate Reality, where all new comics are always 15% off every day for everyone, including all my DC comics, including Supergirl, which has had an up and down creative history over the last couple of years or so. This issue, though, it's got Nick Spencer coming on board as the writer.
Along with some other guy.
And he's taking over the writing chores for this one story arc. And we'll talk a little bit about that in a minute.
Yeah, Sterling Gates and Jamal Igel had a long-standing run on Supergirl. And now what you get is Nick Spencer, comics sort of hot name.
Mm-hmm.
I guess I would call him the hottest name in comics right now.
Well, let's see, Morning Glories.
Yep.
Thunder Agents.
Yep.
Upcoming. Well, War Machine, Iron Man 2.0.
Shortly upcoming.
He's also doing some other stuff over at Image, I believe.
Really?
I think he's got some. There's something else in the pipe over at Image. And now he's got this. And you know what? The seams are splitting on the Nick Spencer writing machine. And so he's going to be on this book. Originally,
we don't know that the seams are splitting.
Well, he's doing a lot of stuff, and originally he was supposed to...
For a new guy in comics to have that much of a load,
yeah,
it is kind of uncommon.
He was supposed to be the new writer on this book. He's going to be on the story arc, and then he's out the door.
You've got to remember he was also doing the Jimmy Olsen backups in Action Comics.
Right.
So, I mean, he has handled his fair share of stuff.
Oh, yeah. Nobody's saying he's not, but it's sort of sad because I would have liked to have seen him stay on this book, and he had to sacrifice this book because of all of his many other commitments.
Judging from this issue, I would have loved to see him stay on this book.
Which is getting into your review. So tell us, how's the book?
It is really, really good in a way that I haven't seen Supergirl ever.
Mm-hmm.
And it does so by building on villains, potential new villains, more so than aping Superman's rogues gallery.
Mm-hmm.
What it does is it sort of creates this dude who is very much some guy you would see at a Starbucks. Sitting around, playing with his phone, trendy looking hipster, kind of a tool, writing
a screenplay.
Maybe. But the idea is this guy is sitting on his phone creating an app that allows people to report in when they spot any sort of caped person about the city. And what that allows him to do is triangulate their location.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? All through social network.
Yeah.
So it's not like some dastardly dude with a satellite he's stolen from the government reprogramming it and beep boop boop beep beep beep.
Mm-hmm.
It's really very much about a dude with this idea of maybe taking down somebody who's bigger than he is as a means of getting his name out there. And he does it in what is both complex and yet at its heart a very simple idea. It's a garage rock band supervillain. It's this guy with the initiative to create this thing and it catches on, or at least it seems to.
So it's another brain over bronze thing, as has always run with Superman, Luthor and Superman.
Sure.
Brainiac and Superman, brains over brawn.
I really like it, because Supergirl isn't supposed to be this big, brawny. I know she's got the Kryptonian strength and everything.
Well, yeah.
But, you know, it's cool to see her have to think around something.
Yeah.
Whereas she just gets to hit stuff all the time.
Well, no, I mean, they should take Supergirl in a different direction from Superman. Or try to,
at
least. And there's a lot... The thing with Supergirl is there's always a lot of room there to do something new with her, not just the fact that she's a female Superman, but that she's another character exactly like Superman, and why don't we just do something different with her instead of, you know, I got to wear glasses, and I got to get a job, and I got to make sure people don't know who I am, and I've got to save everybody all the time.
Kryptonite tampons.
You can't take her off into a different direction while still keeping her in the classic Superman mold, you know, of truth, justice, the American way, and all that stuff. You don't have to turn her into the evil, dark Supergirl, which I know you love Jim Robb doing over in Justice League right now.
If Jim Robb's doing it, I'm not paying attention to it. I haven't seen it.
But anyway, how's the art in this?
It's Bernard Chang. Okay. So it's really, really well done. It's stylized in a way that's animated. It feels like it's moving, but at the same time, it's a classic representation of the character. She looks really good. The characters look emotive. They are expressive. The storytelling is paced very well, mm-hmm. which is something I'm beginning to appreciate more and more, is that as you turn each page, and this is as much a Nick Spencer thing as it is a Bernard Chang thing,
yeah.
but as you turn each page drives you to turn the next. Okay. You know what I mean? It's the story.
There's a build to it.
The story carries itself really well, and there's just the right number of talky scenes, action scenes, things of that nature. So it was really neat. It handled perfectly. And for a guy to come on a book, what is this, the 60th issue? Yeah. 60th issue. It's not an anniversary piece. And to just sort of nail it that well. Bernard Chang is a guy I really like. You know what I mean? I look forward to his stuff on a lot of things. You know?
This is the first part of what I assume is a two-part story arc.
I don't know. It could be bigger than that, but I don't know if Nick Spencer will be sticking around any longer.
Well, it could be as many as three, but this is all Spencer signed on for, and then he's moving on to other pastures. So you may want to come in and pick this up, because this is probably the best Supergirl book that's been out in some time.
Forever?
Well, I don't know about forever, but probably in some time. In some time.
Forever.
Okay. And that's it. We're done. We're finished. We're out of here. We got no more review, but you can go to the store's website and check out all of this guy's reviews that I post up there. And where's the store's website at? Dan.
Why do you always ask me?
Dan.
I don't know.
Dan. Okay. Jeff, where's the store's website?
I asked Sarah.
Somebody help me.
www.myultimaterality.com. I went there once.
So go to the store's website and check out all of his reviews. And until next time, this is Comic Book Man.
This is Sweet Dan Sweet.
Saying,
bye.
Here at Alternate Reality, less is always more, because all new comics are always 15% off here at Alternate Reality. Every day for everyone. Unlike other stores, I have knocked 15% off the cover price of every new comic that's ever walked out the door here, going all the way back to when I first opened in 1994. So why shop anywhere else when you can come down here and save 15% off every day for everyone at Alternate Reality? Alternate Reality is located at 3149 West 111th Street. That's the intersection of 111th and Kedzie in Chicago, the beautiful downtown Mount Greenwood neighborhood. You can always reach us at 773-881-HERO or at the store's website, www.myalternatereality.com.
The Video Outhouse is brought to you by some of the finest people willing to work for free. This is a list of some of them.